Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let's look at how to get an App Store refund from Apple. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. That's where you can read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So from time to time you make a purchase from Apple and you need to get a refund. Maybe it was an accidental purchase. Maybe the app or whatever it is you bought just doesn't work very well. You can request this a couple different ways depending upon if you're on your Mac or on your iPhone. And this works for any iTunes Store purchase. So that's Mac apps, iOS apps, songs, movies, books, anything that you buy from Apple using one of the online stores that's a digital product, but there's no guarantee that you'll actually be able to get a refund. Let's take a look. Now you think if you made a purchase in the Mac App Store that there'll be a way to request a refund in the Mac App Store. Instead you want to go to iTunes. iTunes is still the place you go for accessing all of your purchases across all the digital stores. Now if you're running macOS Catalina by the time you see this, then you go to the Music app. Believe it or not, the Music app is where you go for the same exact functionality. So even if you purchase an app, you want to go to iTunes or the Music app to request a refund. Start by going to the Account menu at the top. There you'll see an option for View My Account. Select that. Then you'll be asked to sign in. On the next screen you scroll down and you'll see Purchase History. And there'll be a button for See All. Here you can see your purchase history and there'll be a little menu here to be able to select a range. So you can go all the way back in time to see some of your earliest purchases. But if you're requesting a refund, you're going to want to stick with the last 90 days because you're not going to be able to get a refund for anything that you purchased more than 90 days ago. So here's an app that I quite like, but let's say I wanted to try to get a refund. I could see here the order ID and a more button. If I click more, I can see a little more information about the app, where I purchased it, when I purchased it, and there's a report a problem button. Click that. Now you'll actually be taken to a website here where you have to sign on again. So once you're signed on, you'll go to a page where you'll see purchases and it will be focused on this one purchase here. And there'll be a pop-up menu here and you can request a refund. Note that there's a little field here. Now somebody is most likely going to review this request. It's going to take a couple of days. You may want to put something in here, especially if you have a really good reason for a refund, like the app has misrepresented itself or maybe it didn't download or it doesn't work on your particular piece of hardware. You want to make sure that you give a decent reason. There are a lot of reasons your request can be rejected. Now there's no definitive list of what to put here or anything, but a lot of people have reported their experiences online. It definitely seems like if you request too many refunds, you're eventually going to start getting denied. That's to prevent people from using this as a way to try an app and then just request a refund if you don't like it. Apple doesn't want you doing that. They want you to make sure that it's an app you want before you buy it and only request a refund if there's an actual real problem. Now note what this screen is actually showing you is a search for the order number here. This is actually a full site, this reportaproblem.apple.com. If you go to the main page for it, you'll actually see all of your purchases here and you can break it down by apps, subscriptions, movies, TV shows, all that kind of thing. It's only going to show recent purchases, ones that qualify for you being able to report a problem and get a refund. So you can skip the whole iTunes thing and just go right to reportaproblem.apple.com to get a refund. So how about on your iPhone? On your iPhone, you actually go into the Settings app. And under there, if you scroll down enough, you'll see iTunes and App Store. Go into that and you tap on at the top where it says Apple ID. Then it's going to have you sign in. On this screen, look for Purchase History. Now you'll see something very similar to what you saw on iTunes on the Mac. At the top, you'll see Last 90 Days. You can change that, but there's no point if you're trying to get a refund. Then you can look through the apps that you've purchased. When you see the app, tap where you see Total Build. That'll take you to the order. Then tap the app icon here on this screen. This will take you to a page where there's a Report a Problem button. Tap that and guess what? It launches Safari and goes to the Report a Problem site, the same place that you end up on the Mac. So you can actually go to reportaproblem.apple.com in Safari on your iPhone and get right to a list of all your apps and look through them there. You eventually end up at the app here where you can choose the problem just like before. You can write a description of the issue and you could submit a request for the refund. So here's some things that you should know. First of all, don't bother requesting an app refund from the developer. The developer has no power to actually issue a refund. The store is owned by Apple. All the processing, all the payment handling is owned by Apple. The developer doesn't even know who you are, who purchased the app. And there's no way for them on their end to request a refund for you. So just go directly to Apple. I've already said that it's got to be within 90 days that you request a refund. The option isn't even there for anything older. But even then you may not get your refund. Results really vary if you read people's experiences online. I definitely hear that people that request lots of refunds eventually get denied, so you want to use this sparingly. One of the main reasons people request refunds is another family member has made a purchase without their permission. You can easily prevent this on your iPhone by using Touch ID or Face ID. Either one of those means you're going to have to use that authentication method with each purchase. In the App Store app on your Mac, there's a setting under Preferences for how often a password is required for a purchase. The only two options are every 15 minutes or for every single purchase. Now I know I'm going to get asked about subscriptions. You see it in the same place in iTunes as you go to look at your purchases, except it's under Settings and you'll see Subscriptions right here. Click Manage. You'll see all your current subscriptions and expired ones as well. You can go to Edit. And you can use the cancel subscription button, then you won't get charged the next time. And in the Settings app under iTunes and App Store, you'll find a subscriptions button there as well. It doesn't look like anybody had much luck getting a refund for a subscription. It sounds like once you authorize a subscription to be charged, you're stuck with it. And if you forget to cancel the subscription before the next month or year or whenever it is, you're stuck with that as well. So if you really don't want that subscription to renew, make sure you cancel it well ahead of time. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.